For Cosby, the address is CBS.
Hello, ladies. Happy holidays.
Sir, I think you might find things a little more to your liking in the large and lovely section.
You again.
So, what's going on? You going undercover, or is this just a little hobby of yours?
Nice dress.
What, this old thing? So, tell me, did you track down any leads on your wife's wedding ring?
No, the pawn shop, I traced it to. The guys didn't know zip about it, who they bought it from.
Well, that stinks.
No, hey, you run into a dead end, you back up, find yourself a new route.
And that route led you straight to fashions.
No. I just decided I would cash in on some Christmas cheer. Obviously, some people do it for themselves.
Excuse me. My mother and I happen to be the same dress size, and this is for her, if I so choose.
So choose? Not bad. It's nice to see that you have some hidden taste after all.
Oh, well, thank you. Thank you very much. Oh, my. What's in there? Anything for me?
Well, I couldn't find a bag that would hold that big lump of coal, but believe me, I'm still looking.
Oh, yeah? What do we have here? Oh, wow. Somebody has been a very good girl for Christmas.
That's from Vicky.
I don't know how many different ways you need to hear this. What if I sign a statement, make a sworn confession that I had nothing to do with the murder of Alec Wallace? You know what? Because this has been a huge waste of my time.
All right, let's go over this one more time.
All right, fine. The night Alec was murdered, I was at home with my son.
Is there anyone who can attest to that?
My mother was at work, Allison was asleep, and, oh, Daniel won't be able to testify until he's about 3 or 4. So unless you intend to keep me here until then...
You know, don't tempt us.
I did not leave my son at home alone so I could go shoot and kill a man I barely know. Sorry to disappoint you, Tom.
Let me do this.
Am I under arrest?
No, you're not.
Fine. Then, you know what? I've been more than polite, and you have no right keeping me here. I'd like to go home now.
Or you'll have a lawsuit on your hands before you know what hits you. I'm Miss Stewart's attorney.
Well, it's about time.
What is this? What are you, selling tickets while you interrogate my client without benefit of counsel? Interesting technique. I'll inform the DA.
I just have a few more questions.
No, they've kept me here all night, okay? I've answered every humiliating question they could possibly ask me.
Jack, got your message. What's going on here?
I'll tell you what's going on. These geniuses think I murdered Alec Wallace, okay? They've kept me here all night.
She could have left anytime she wanted, Al.
No evidence. No proof that I've done anything wrong,
okay,
Al.
Okay, Emily, just take it easy. If you give me 1 minute with my officer, I'll get right back to you, okay? Jack?
You want to tell me what the hell is going on?
Emily Stewart's the most likely suspect we have.
Now, you listen to me, Jack, and you listen good. Whether we like it or not, the verdict is in against Margot, and this case is closed.
I think
you apologize to Emily, and you get her out of here quietly now.
Hey. Could we have a minute alone? How are you holding up?
Oh, I'm a lot better now that you're here.
What's going on? I mean, I know you pretty well. I can tell when something's not right. What's going on with you today?
Had a after-hours visitor last night.
Yeah, who?
Alec.
What happened? I mean, what did he say?
He didn't say anything, but he was trying to give me a clue. It was a definite clue. It was a scarf. He showed me a silk scarf.
Do you remember what it looked like?
Yeah, it was white, and it had big, colorful butterflies all over it.
I knew it. I knew it.
What?
The security tape from the Lakeview. The woman who was on the elevator around the time of Alex's murder.
Yeah.
She was wearing a scarf. A white one with butterflies on it, just like you described.
Oh, my God.
Now, Carly got a look at the videotape and positively ID'd it as a Barbara Ryan original, top of the line.
Oh, my God.
So all we need to do is establish a link between the videotape, the scarf, and Emily.
If Emily is the woman I heard in Alex's apartment that night.
You hold that thought.
Happy holidays, fashions.
Hi, Mom, it's me. I need your help.
Well, hi, honey. You have a fashion emergency this early in the day.
The BRO scarves that you have in stock, I need to trace one, a white one with colorful butterflies on it.
You know, that is a fashion's exclusive. We're the only store in the state that has that available.
That's great. This is really important, Mom. Do you recall who you sold those scarves to?
You mean right off the top of my head? Honey, what's this all about?
Margo's freedom.
With all the ginkgo biloba in the world, I can't recall selling a single one of those butterfly scarves to anyone.
Maybe Barbara sold it, Mom. One of your other employees. Can you get me a list of your employees, their names, their numbers?
Wait, I might be able to do you one better. I have this new computerized system that is supposed to keep track of who bought what.
Fantastic.
Yeah. Fantastic if I can work it. The thing is so temperamental, it doesn't seem to want to work for me.
Mom, I need the list.
I'll do everything in my power to help.
I'll talk to you soon, Mom. If anybody, one person on that list knew Alec Wallace, we just might have our real killer even today.
As the World Turns is brought to you today by Charmin Ultra. Where would you be without it?
Now that everybody knows about Nushan, we're booking Ritai
again.
He's here.
Happy retirement, Joey!
I can't retire now. I have to tell folks they've improved Charmin Double Roll.
I'm seeing double. Because it's twice as long as the Charmin Single Roll.
Double.
And stronger and more absorbent.
Ooh. He's not retiring.
New Charmin Double Roll and Triple Roll, too.
Remember the other day when someone asked if we were sisters? Well, in case you couldn't tell from my face, I was flattered. You are one of the most beautiful women I know. So, now that we're sisters and all, shouldn't we be sharing our beauty secrets?
Oh, Mom, you taught me everything I know.
The Olay Holiday Gift Set, proven to make her feel beautiful. Now Olay brings you lasting cosmetics that care.
Is a taste for adventure.
First, the bad news. That red nose your cold's giving you, your tissue may be making it worse. Blow after blow, a tissue can irritate your already vulnerable skin. Puffs Plus. It soothes better than that other national brand because it has lotion with aloe and vitamin E. Get the most soothing puffs ever. Puffs Plus. It feels better because it soothes better.
Hey!
Hey! There you are, my darling. Sweetheart, I was hoping that we could have breakfast together today.
Oh, I took a walk.
You want something to warm you up? Would you like an omelet with everything in it, the way Rosa does it?
No. Thanks, I'm not very hungry.
Upset by all this mess?
Yeah. Yeah, you could say that.
Come on. The thing that I want to say is, I find it very strange that people are sentencing this woman when they should be giving her a medal. Alec Wallace was a criminal. He was destructive. He was vicious. He should be an example to all others of his ilk, that what goes around comes around. And from my point of view, he got it too easy.
But he was Eddie's father.
Sweetheart, Eddie got along without him before, and he'll do just fine without him in the picture now. Could you smile, please?
Yeah.
Could you trust me?
Yeah.
Could you give me a hug? Oh, I've been wanting to talk to you.
Hey, guys. Sorry to barge in.
Hey.
Hello. I was just thinking about you. Hi.
I'll go talk to Rosa.
So you didn't sleep again last night?
No, man. I just keep hoping that I'm going to wake up one of these mornings and this whole thing is just going to be a bad nightmare. Wonder if they're selling a lot of papers.
It just makes me sick to think that she could go to prison and be away from her kids and from Tom and her life and everything.
I never thought it would go down like this. Never in a million years did I think that this was what was going to happen. I still wonder what it would be like if Alec was still around, you know? I mean, we'd be off on a trip together. Patching things up, I'd finally get to know my father. Hey, you don't need to be upset, okay? I'm okay. Everything is okay.
I'm so sorry, Eddie. I'm sorry.
Me both.
I shouldn't have listened to Alec. I should have just told you right when I found out that he was your father, and this wouldn't have happened. You would have gotten to know him. Margo wouldn't be in trouble.
Hey, George, look. I know that I was really angry with you for not telling me at first, but George, I was spouting a lot of garbage. I don't know what I would have done if I lost you.
Oh, I could never lose you. You are everything, everything to me. We have been through so much together. And when I thought I had lost you, I went to Margo and I asked for her advice, and she reassured me that you would forgive me and that you would forgive both of us, and now just, God, this should not be happening to her.
Hey, you know, we should probably go and see her.
No, she's with Tom, and we shouldn't bother them.
Bother? What bother? The woman has been there for me every time I needed her. I want to be there for her now.
Okay.
Come here. Everybody needs moral support, right? Everybody.
You got this for Vicky for Christmas?
Yeah, I mean, I know I live a little overboard. It's just a bunch of metal and some rocks. I guess I'm coming a little unhinged with the holidays coming up and Vicky missing.
No. Everything. Come on. You came unhinged a long, long time ago, probably during your misguided youth.
It's kind of a backup gift in case Vicky shows up and I don't have anything for her. I'll never hear the end of it.
Come on,
there's no way that ring just showed up on Lake Michigan. What do you think? It just squeezed off her finger and fell to the bottom and swam ashore? That's not the way it happened.
Well, come on. What other explanation is there?
The bodyguard. I heard with my own ears him leave a message on Wallace's answering machine saying that he'd taken care of it, that it was a done deal. And then what's the last thing he says to me is he jumps off the edge. He says, I'll never know.
Okay, but that could mean...
It could mean anything. Let me tell you something. A couple nights ago, I almost gave up. I just wanted to crawl underneath my covers with my bottle of scotch and like he's not coming back. I said to myself, I mean, this is hopeless. But then I heard. I thought about her. I thought about her giving up and giving in. I'm not gonna do that. I mean, if there is even a minuscule chance that she's alive, then that's what I'm not going. I am not going to give up because she would not give up on me.
Yeah, and I bet you gave her plenty of reasons to.
Ah, you don't know the half. She was gone last Christmas. Nobody knew where she went or what happened to her, but I knew. I knew she was alive. I knew she was alive. I knew it in here. It's kind of... It's connection thing.
Yeah.
You know, if you have something to say, then you want you just say it. Now, what do you want to do? You want to call the guys in the white suits with the butterfly net and say, you know, whoa, McKinnon, he's gone off the deep end,
okay,
huh?
Okay, just give me a little bit of credit. I knew you were nuts a long time ago. Do I think you're crazy because you believe that your wife is out there? You know what? If I was in the same situation, I'd probably feel exactly the same way. But I want to tell you something. If Vicky does show up before Christmas, the last thing she's going to be concerned about is what's under the tree. Now, what about her boys, huh? What are they doing for Christmas?
Oh, they're gonna go to Bay City and see their aunt and their grandma.
Okay, so have you hit the toy stores?
A couple, yeah.
A couple? Come on, what about Kressler's downtown? The Enchanted Forest? Oh, my God, you are kidding me. Okay, let me shed this gown. I'm going to take care of a few things, and then we are going to load up on the best Christmas toys those kids have ever seen.
Julian, I know you really don't want to do this.
Of course I want to.
And we had to move fast before Emily caught on and could possibly destroy evidence.
If there is any. A tape of a woman in a scarf in an elevator doesn't mean a damn thing.
Unless the woman turns out to be Emily Stewart. Margot's about to be shipped off to prison for something that we all know she didn't do.
I don't want Margot in prison any more than you do. But you don't have squat on Emily Stewart. And you can't go above the law by trampling on her rights. You let her go, Jack, now.
You're free to go.
About time.
Emily. Can I talk to her for a minute?
It's all right. I'll meet you up front. Talk. I've got nothing to say to you.
Yeah, well, this is about Daniel. My son. Under the circumstances, I think he should be staying.
And the circumstances being you'd rather railroad me into prison than let Margot serve the time she deserves?
I don't want to run a marathon. I don't want to go skydiving. I don't want to feel like a kid again. Though, not feeling ancient would be nice. All I really want is to be able to climb the stairs and give Michael a bath.
Vioxx is here, a prescription medicine for the most common type of arthritis pain, osteoarthritis. One little pill, taken just once a day, can provide 24-hour relief. In rare cases, serious stomach problems such as bleeding can occur without warning. People with allergic reactions such as asthma to aspirin or other arthritis medicines should not take Vioxx. Tell your doctor if you have liver or kidney problems. For more information, ask your doctor or pharmacist about once-daily Vioxx for the relief of osteoarthritis pain. And you may be able to plan your day around your life instead of your pain. Vioxx, for everyday victories.
They say if you get the flu, take plenty of fluids. But we think you'll feel much better taking them with a pouch of new Honey Flu, the first effective flu medicine made with real honey in a convenient, ready-to-pour pouch. New Honey Flu, a natural choice for the flu, from Robitussin.
Wow, winter's a blast, but tough on your lips. Flavor Craze to the rescue. Totally Chapstick for serious lip protection. Radical. Flavor Craze protects like Chapstick.
Tastes like fun.
Now in three new fruit flavors.
This old mop makes me shake.
That old vacuum makes me ache.
Plain old sprays can smear around.
This box rocks. The radical new Swiffer Sweeper. So simple to assemble.
A Swiffer now I'm sliding.
Sweeping and a gliding.
Here comes Swiffer Sweeper.
Swiffer cloths use electrostatic action and lift and lock pockets to attract and trap all kinds of stuff with no residue. When you're done, just toss it.
Here comes Swiffer Sweeper.
When Swiffer's the one, consider it done. It makes a perfect holiday gift.
Thursday.
Clear.
Go beyond the ER.
I got a code blue over here. Let's get moving.
Where there's hope for the new millennium.
Showtime.
Chicago Hope, CBS Thursday.
It's a hell of a solution to losing a case, don't you think? Huh? Get me locked up and steal my son? Get Margot off and win a prize. Well, I got news for you. You find yourself another patsy because you're never, never taking away my son.
Yeah, well, I got news for you. This scenario fits. The way you've been hounding me for months.
Hounding
stalking
you? Is that how you felt?
Me and Margot, stalking Alec and Margot. Then tell me. Tell me you weren't up at the cabin on the night of the storm. Tell me that you didn't drop sand in Margot's gas tank so she would have to spend the night there. Because of you, Margot's letter to Alec wound up in the prosecution's hand.
Your wife committed that passion to paper, not me. And stalking? Your wife slept with another man. Would you like to punish me for that, too?
No, just tell the truth for once.
You want to know the truth? You want to know the awful truth? I adored you. I would have moved heaven on earth so you realize how much I loved you and how hopelessly wrong Margot was for you. But I was a fool. I mean, after everything that's happened, after all the betrayal and accusations and degradation, I realize what a fool I've been. You and Margot deserve each other. Thank you for opening my eyes.
You brought this on yourself.
I never thought I'd apologize for loving you. But I do. I apologize to myself. I'm sorry I ever laid eyes on you. I'm sorry I was so blind. You know, I could go a lifetime and be happy that I never see you again.
As nice as that would be for both of us, we have a child together.
You stay away from my son. I have custody. You have no rights.
Don't I?
Daniel is my son. My son. You push me on this, I swear to God, you'll regret it.
Tom, your mom just called. She found what we're looking for.
Thank you. Hey.
Hey, Margo.
This is a nice surprise.
How are you doing?
Oh, well, just trying to come up with a Christmas list for Adam and Casey. I thought I'd be out of here in time to get it all done. Tom's going crazy,
so... We could help you do it.
No, you can't, because it's a really long list, and it's last-minute Christmas.
Margo, it's no sweat. Really, we'd love to do it for you.
Would you? This is the best Christmas gift, though, you two visiting me.
Where else would we be, Margot? Huh.
I just wish I could be out and celebrate with everybody, you guys included. Oh, what a year, huh? First Tom and me doing battle, and then we break up, now this. But at least you two have gotten back together, found each other. There are some happy endings. Somebody gets some good fortune, huh?
Yeah, some prayers have been answered.
Some? Check out the kid from the other side of the tracks, now a millionaire, huh?
Oh, I'm telling you, Margot, that money isn't worth one penny to me, not one penny, if I can't use it to get you out of here. I mean, the thought of you doing time.
Can't they appeal? I mean, maybe there's some evidence that could make you free, or...
Tom's really optimistic. He's turning over every angle. I wish I could be as up as him, but... I just can't, you know, after everything that's happened this year. But they have come up with some new leads. So.
Leads?
Really? That's great. What are they?
The lead's a dead end. And you will not blame this one on me, Marco.
Okay, I'll bite. What is that big red guy's list of who's been naughty and who's been nice?
Something like that.
Hey, Mom, what do you got?
What is this half price for men day at,
Hi, are you absolutely certain this is the scarf you saw the mystery woman wear?
Yeah. Yeah, this is the one.
Well, we had very few made and even fewer sold.
To how many women, Lisa?
Three.
Three?
Yes, and all three have a connection to Alec Wallace.
What if you could treat wrinkles like an expert would? With Roc, the number one anti-wrinkle cream in France, you can. Developed with dermatologists, Roc's pure and active form of vitamin A works deeper inside skin surface. In a 12-week study, the appearance of fine lines was reduced by 86%, wrinkles by 42%. Something more superficial beauty treatments could never promise. Rock. We keep our promises.
Dr. Scholl's next stop, San Francisco.
Let's talk about feet.
I do have corns.
I've tried Band-Aids.
They don't get rid of the corn.
This is Dr. Scholl's Cushion Gel Corn Removers.
The Cushlin Gel relieves the pain.
The medicated disc removes the corn.
It just feels so much better.
My work here is done.
I was one hurting cowboy. Heartburn hotter than a blown engine. And pain? The antacid I took didn't do the whole job. And Pepsi takes so long. Then I tried Alka-Seltzer. Man, if it didn't work, a whole lot better.
Alka-Seltzer, the only one with the medicines to relieve all your symptoms.
Boy, it works fast.
And only Alka-Seltzer has the effervescent power to speed relief.
Alka-Seltzer. Made a believer out of me.
Get better relief. Get Alka-Seltzer.
Don't touch! No. Hold it! My family touches everything, so to fight bacteria, I switched from Lysol to something new.
New Clorox Disinfecting Spray, a breakthrough in fighting bacteria. Watch. Lysol's protection fades as the surface is touched, but Clorox keeps killing 99.9% of bacteria around the clock up to 24 hours. New Clorox Disinfecting Spray, the only one that kills 99.9% of bacteria for 24 hours.
This holiday season, when you buy an action-packed RC car at Radio Shack, you get a free official Stuart Little yo-yo from the Stuart Little movie, only in theaters. For RC excitement and the only place to get the official Stuart Little yo-yo, get in, get out, get what you want. Radio Shack.
Asthma. Millions suffer from it. Details of a new experimental treatment tonight.
A late husband's diary reveals a hidden past. Was there another woman?
I need to know.
What this family finds will make a wish come true. The Christmas Wish, CBS tonight.
Thursday, join NSYNC, Leanne Rimes, and the legendary Stevie Wonder, plus many more, as CBS proudly pays tribute to the families who gave children the ultimate gift of love, a home to call their own.
Doesn't matter they were adopted. They're my kids.
I feel their love.
A home for the holidays, CBS Thursday.
So did you come up with the brilliant scapegoat concept, or was that Tom's idea?
Well, it makes perfect sense to me, and the rest of the world, for that matter. I mean, you did try to frame me for a mugging I didn't commit. You got me bounced from two jobs. Oh, yeah, and you killed that guy.
Well, that was an accident.
Why not frame Margot for murder?
I did not kill your father, Eddie.
Says you. We'll see what the jury thinks.
Just let it go. Yeah, Eddie. Good advice. Let it go. You can afford to let it go, can't you? Count your blessings, Eddie, and your millions. See, from what I can tell, dying and making you rich was the nicest thing your old man ever did.
Because you're right in your face.
Just like you.
It's just not worth it.
Oh, said the convicted killer. That's the Margot we all know and love, isn't it? Even in jail, behind bars, she sits in judgment of the rest of us. Well, I got news for you. I wouldn't be so nasty to the girls in cell block B because they won't, well, they won't treat you so nice, Margot.
Margot won't be going to prison, Emily.
If blaming me was your get-out-of-jail-free card, Marco, you are barking up the wrong tree, because I didn't do a damn thing.
What about the new leads?
None of them leads to me, Eddie.
Yeah, well, we'll see about that.
Whatever. You know, I don't have time for this. Look at me. Margo, look me in the eyes. I know it seems like a lifetime ago, but we used to be friends. Do you honestly believe I killed Alec Wallace?
Well, you know what I think? I think he did it.
You know, you really ought to put a muzzle on your boyfriend.
Just ignore her.
You may have committed the unpardonable sin of falling in love with your husband. But you think I would risk my freedom, my child's future, by killing a man to get Tom Hughes? He's good, but he's not that good. So you know what? Enjoy those conjugal visits. I am so through with him. He's all yours.
She is just crude. Are you okay?
Oh, nothing she can say can ever hurt me. The only problem is now, I know for sure that she didn't kill your father.
Mom? Tell them that Emily is one of the three people on that list that bought that scarf.
But she isn't.
however her mother is.
Susan Stewart?
She doesn't have a motive.
What are you talking about? Like Emily couldn't get her hands on her mother's scarf? She lives in the same house. She has access to all her belongings.
Of course, that wouldn't be difficult.
All right, we'll deal with that. What about the rest of the names on that list?
Look, you've got a link to your number one suspect. Why bring the other women into this?
I need to see the entire list, Lisa. I can get a warrant, but that probably wouldn't be good for business during the Christmas rush, you know.
Is there someone you're trying to protect?
Now, why would I want to protect Lucinda Walsh? I mean, that would be a switch now, wouldn't it?
Wait, hold on a second. You can't possibly believe that Lucinda Walsh has anything to do with this. I mean, she hated the man, but so did everybody else. She wouldn't go gunning for him.
They were fierce competitors.
That's business.
What if she had a personal reason for
what? What reason, Hal? What reason could she possibly have? She was suspicious. She was protective. And she held a grudge tighter than most. But what do you think she did? You tell me. What do you think she did? You think she killed him and then set somebody up, Margot, and then sat back and watched?
Now, I have never been an admirer of this woman. I have called her a lot of names in the past, but never a murderer.
You
never.
Said that there were three names on that list. Who's the last one?
Hey, Jake. Sorry I'm late. I did. What's everybody doing here?
A five-position watering nozzle from Rainbird, which I found online and at thousands of retail stores. Now, it may be perfect for the garden, but a bank heist? I don't think so.
StoreRunner.com has shopping experts in every conceivable field, like Tracy Carrero in garden supplies.
Oh, my mother has a pair of those. Cut-and-hold rose pruners from Smith & Hawken, also available online and at 44 retail stores.
StoreRunner.com. Log on. Let's shop. Yeah.
This is power. Unstoppable power. The power in new Duracell Ultra. The most powerful alkaline battery in the world. The power for more pictures, faster flashes, more sound, and ultra performance in whatever it powers. New Duracell Ultra. More power, more life. In this life, there's just no stopping. No break for a hacking cough. No rest for a raw, sore throat, aches, fever. But when you're desperate for relief, there is Theraflu. Fast, powerful, hot liquid therapy. With the first sip of that soothing hot liquid, you feel relief is on the way. Soon your throat is soothed, your cough calmed. Maximum strength Theraflu. Now in new honey lemon chest congestion and cough. Instant comfort, powerful relief.
Do you want your parties to be really special? Try Rocher, the European speciality your guests will adore. Smooth chocolate, crunchy hazelnut, a luxurious taste sensation. It's more of a party with Rocher.
George, the Sprint store at Radio Shack was a great idea for holiday shopping.
Only at Radio Shack, when you give any Sprint PCS phone, you'll get gifts too. $30 back by mail and a free Astro Millennium Countdown Clock ornament. The Sprint store at Radio Shack.
For a man in power, control is everything. For a man who's a player, the game is everything.
Damn it!
And for those who want it all, the number one daytime network is everything.
You ain't seen nothing yet.
There's never been a better time to get into it. Weekdays on CBS.
It's everything.
Now, a CBS2 Toy Drive update.
A good afternoon, everybody. Tony Williams live at Universal City Walk. A growing pile of toys. Look at all these we've got. Barbie and Star Fairies and everything. And look at all these little volunteers that have come out. Hi, everybody.
Hi, Channel 2.
Good work. We've got Santa up here.
Merry Christmas.
We're live till 6:30. Universal City Walk. We need toys.
We
try
need
to come
toys.
On out here. Till 6:30.
Thousands of Southern California children share the same holiday wish. Join Catherine Anaya for a new look at adoption tonight at 11 on CBS 2 News. Then Thursday, a tribute to families who gave the ultimate gift of love. A Home for the Holidays, Thursday at 8.
There's no store like ours anywhere. One whole city block just loaded with bedspreads, comforters, and drapes.
The sales staff is great here. They give terrific advice, and if you can't find it here, it doesn't exist.
I've been to all the major department stores. This one has the fantastic selections, the quality buys.
If you can't find it here, you won't find it anywhere.
The Bedspread Kingdom, one old city block in Long Beach.
Happy holidays.
From all of us at CBS2.
The address is CBS.
Hey, is something wrong? I mean, what, are my pants on backwards or something?
No, actually, it's your scarf.
What about it? What's wrong with it?
Well, honey, it's...
Julia,
it's...
that scarf could be evidence in the murder of Alec Wallace.
We, found a new lead that could point us to the real killer.
You can't think that I was involved because I bought a scarf.
Please.
Where were you the night that Alec Wallace was murdered?
I can hardly remember what happened last night, let alone a few weeks ago.
She was with me. Yeah, we were at the airport waiting for my wife's plane.
I'm sure there are people at the airport who can back that up.
I'm sure you're gonna do your job and find out.
Now look, you fellas, please just leave this sweet girl alone. Go after the person you really need, and that's Emily.
Julian, can I talk to you for a second? I'm really sorry about this. I am, but should I be worried about you here? I mean, you've been involved with some pretty dangerous stuff lately. Bombs, murderers, dead bodies.
No, I'm fine.
You sure?
Really, yeah. Yeah, I've learned a lot the past few months, and... well, I'm stronger than you might think.
Jack, go see Lucinda Walsh. Pick up that scarf. Tell her it can be voluntary, or we can get a warrant. I'll pay a visit to Susan Stewart.
Yeah, me too.
Tom, you have no authority.
You know what? My son is in that house. I'll be damned if I'm gonna let you or anyone else to keep me from making sure he's safe.
All right, at least that way I know you're staying out of trouble. Thanks, Lisa. Jack, see you at the station.
Mom, I'll talk to you.
Julia, darling, I apologize from the bottom of my heart.
What? You know, I'm the one who bought the scarf. Everything's gonna be just fine, I'm sure. It's gonna be okay.
I think I need a break, if you will excuse me.
What?
I cannot believe that you were actually considering the possibility that I killed Alec Wallace.
Believe me, guys, part of me, a big part of me wants it to be Emily that killed your dad so we can just go on with our lives.
Well, what are you remembering that makes you think it's not Emily?
It's the crying. I remember hearing a woman cry. It's not very clear, but my gut is just telling me that it's not Emily, and I keep trying to remember something, anything to lead us in a definite direction.
Well, you know, I mean, you will remember. It's just, you know, maybe you're trying too hard.
Margo, I'm feeling so bad that you're here. Is there anything else that we can do besides your Christmas shopping?
Yeah. There is.
Name it.
Why don't you take some of that money that you just inherited and just get out of town? Both of you, go someplace exciting and relaxing and exotic, someplace far away, huh?
No, it's like you've been reading George's mind or something. But we can't just pick up and leave right now.
Yeah, you can. I've got Tom and Hal and Jack and most of the cops on the police force trying to get me out of here.
Well, yeah, I know that, but...
No buts about it. I want you to leave here and go to a travel agency. You take your toothbrush and your passport and get out of town. And the only thing I ask is that maybe you send me a postcard every couple of days and let me know that you're having the time of your lives. Understand?
No, I can't do it.
Yes, you can.
No.
Yes, you can, Georgia. This is an order. You take this man out of town and you have a great time. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
And Eddie? Just do this for me. Just do it. Because after everything you've been through this year, you need to go someplace and leave all this insanity behind you. She's right, Eddie. You know, there isn't much we can do. And Margo's gonna be okay. Tom will help her get out of here.
Oh, yeah, any day.
I'm not gonna promise you anything, Margo, but I'll consider it, okay?
Emily, finally! Oh, honey, how are you?
Oh, how am I? How do you think I am? Browbeaten all night by Jack Snyder and the incomparable Tom Hughes.
I called every lawyer we know. I'm
yeah,
sorry
I know, I know. He showed up a half a minute before they released me.
I mean, they came after me like a pack of dogs, you know? And Tom, ugh, if I could just get my hands on him, pretending he gives a damn about me. Jack was all over me, you know, and Tom, he just stood there. It was like he was enjoying himself.
Oh, baby, that must have been so awful.
Oh, awful. Awful doesn't come close, Mom. He's a traitor. I mean, he'll do everything in his power to get Margo off, including serving me up to the cops. He doesn't care. What did I ever see in him?
Baby, you are so much better off without him. I've said that from the start. Mm. Now you just have to get on with your life. Forget about him. Do what's best for Daniel.
Daniel is what is best for me. You know what else he said? You know what he wants to do? He wants Daniel. He wants Daniel to live with him. Well, I'll tell you, it'll be a cold day in hell before Tommy Hughes ever takes my son. God's sake, who's there?
How? Tom, what are you doing here?
You better lock up your shoes, Mom. They have a serious fetish.
Susan, we're here to pick up some evidence. It's a white butterfly scarf you purchased at Fashions.
Of your life, just you against your smoking addiction, one-on-one. Trouble is, it's not a fair fight, and few people win it. But you can give yourself a fighting chance to win with Zyban. Zyban doesn't work for everyone. Zyban is part of a comprehensive program from your doctor to help you stop smoking. It's different from nicotine replacements. Zyban is the only prescription medicine that's nicotine-free, so you don't have to stop smoking all at once. As Zyban reduces your cravings, you feel like smoking less and less until you're ready to stop completely because you're ready to win. You should know there is a risk of seizure associated with Zyban. To reduce the risk, don't take Zyban if you have or have had a seizure or eating disorder, or if you take Wellbutrin. Don't take Zyban if you use an MAO inhibitor. Side effects may include dry mouth and difficulty sleeping. Ask your doctor if Zyban is right for you because it can help you quit smoking by making it a fight you can win. Zyban, you don't have to quit all at once. Comfort. It's what makes your baby happy. That's why there's Carnation Good Start, the only routine formula whose proteins are broken down to be easy to digest. They're called comfort proteins, and only Good Start has them. Carnation Good Start from Nestle.
Hey guys, soup's on!
Campbell's Chicken Noodle Soup lets kids use their hands, their mouths, and their imagination. Stupid soup. Want to serve your kids the world's first interactive snack? We have a soup for that. Campbell's Chicken Noodle.
Of course you think I'm a murderer.
I don't think you're a murderer.
Then why did you do that?
Do what?
Lie to the police.
I gave you an alibi.
Exactly. You lost your mind.
You know something? I'm starting to think I did.
What did you think that you were doing? What were you trying to accomplish?
Excuse me for trying to protect you.
Oh, okay. Well, you know what? Who named you my protector? I can take care of myself. Thank you very much.
I can take care of myself. Thank you very much. You should be on your knees thanking me for not letting them drag you down to the police station and question you.
Oh, yeah. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much for putting me into a whole load of trouble.
Oh, you
lying to the police.
You could stop me. Why don't you call your old pal Jack? Set things straight.
Well, that's a great idea. Why don't I just call him up and tell him the truth? They'll think I'm lying, and then they'll really think that I did
it. All right. I'm sorry.
Oh, gee. That sounded really sincere. Look. The next time you get the bright idea to protect me, ask me. Or at least warn me first.
Fine.
Good. Now we understand each other.
I wouldn't go that far.
Come on. We gotta hit the toy stores before all the good stuff is gone. That is, if you still want company.
No, I was thinking about what you said earlier. I think I'm gonna head back to Bay City, make sure nobody's speaking with a British accent. Spend some extra time with the kids.
Well, that's a great idea, Jake.
I'm sorry. Thank you. Thank you for the offer to go shopping, and thank you for the advice.
Consider it my gift to you. Merry Christmas, Jake.
Merry Christmas, Julia.
Hey, hi, Jack. What can I do?
Oh, my. Is this an unexpected and unannounced visit from Officer Snyder?
Miss Walsh.
Okay. Well, I guess you're not collecting for the police athletic league?
No, but I am collecting evidence, however, concerning the death of Alec Wallace.
Evidence? You don't say. It's so strange when I think of it, because we've had a trial, we've had a conviction.
Do you own a white butterfly scarf?
Sure. But of course you knew I did.
Yeah, well, we need to have it checked out. I could get a warrant, but I was hoping you'd be cooperative.
No. Please, that's not necessary at all. I mean, never let it be said that Lucinda Walsh was anything but a responsible citizen. You don't, you move!
Thank you.
Hey, Jackie.
Hey, guys.
What are you doing here?
I'm afraid it's official.
He's here
business.
Because he's collecting for the Oakdale annual scarf drive.
Thank you very much.
Hey, Jack, what's going on? Were you collecting evidence here?
Do you want to show me to another room?
No, I have nothing to hide from anybody. You want to ask me a couple of questions, right? And I'd like to ask you a question or two. You want to know where I was on the night that Alec Wallace was killed?
Yes. You can't do this, Jack.
It's okay, darling. It's perfectly all right. It's very simple. Where was I? I was home. Here, until I got a very terrible and frightening telephone call from the airport about my jet, which disappeared, so I rushed out so I could be with Jake McKinnon, my editor-in-chief, who was waiting for his wife.
Well, the airport was a busy spot that night. We may need you to come down and make a formal statement.
That's fine. I don't mind. May I ask you a simple question?
Sure.
Who else is the scarf fairy visiting this morning?
Julia Lindsay, Susan Stewart.
Susan? Susan Stewart?
Yes. Well, enjoy the rest of your morning. We'll be in touch. Excuse me.
Hey, Lou, they can't do this. There's no way that you killed Alec. Didn't you just finish turning this house upside down looking for that godforsaken scarf?
We'll be out of your way as soon as we can, Emily.
Oh, okay, okay. You finished raking me over the coals. Now it's my mother's turn. Or is this a new police technique, Hal? Guilty until proven otherwise. Oh, no, maybe this is Tom's idea. Maybe he thinks I took the scarf to incriminate my own mother.
Let's get this over with.
Yeah, please. Give him the scarf so they can get the hell out of here.
I can't find it.
Well, keep looking, Mother.
I have looked everywhere.
It's just, it's disappeared.
No, no, no. Scarves don't just disappear.
What? I didn't do this.
Give us a call if it turns up. Don't leave town. We need to ask you a few more questions.
You lost the scarf? What, are you kidding me? That's the nail in the coffin they're building for me, Mother, of all the times for you to be absent-minded.
I know where my scarves are kept. Do you?
What is that supposed to mean?
Did you do this? Did you murder Alec Wallace?
If you're one of the 36 million people who wear dentures, this is big. New 5-Minute Polident cleans stains, then forms an invisible PolyShield barrier so you feel fresh all day. 5-Minute Polident with PolyShield.
All right, kid. Here we go.
10-9.
What do you got? What do you got?
What?
Yeah.
All right, come on, come on.
What would you do if someone you loved had a heart attack? Did you know it's now been proven that the same Bayer aspirin you have in your bag for muscle aches may actually help stop you from dying if you take it during a heart attack?
Downtown! Lucky shot!
Can your pain reliever do that? Talk to your doctor now.
Next time I'll go easier on you.
Bayer. Powerful pain relief and so much more.
This holiday season, when you buy an action-packed RC car at Radio Shack, you get a free official Stuart Little yo-yo from the Stuart Little movie, only in theaters. For RC excitement and the only place to get the official Stuart Little yo-yo, get in, get out, get what you want. Radio Shack.
You lingered over the coffee pot. Now you can eclipse it. A spicy lunch and your breath is hot. Now you can eclipse it.
Discover new Eclipse Gum from Wrigley. Each piece delivers a powerful burst of fresheners that quickly eliminate the strongest mouth odors.
Say goodbye to all of that. Erase bad breath in seconds flat. Now you can eclipse it, yeah. Now you can eclipse it.
It's new Eclipse Sugar-Free Gum from Wrigley.
Tums is the most popular antacid in America. Tums is recommended by more doctors than any other antacid. Tums is so safe, it's recommended for pregnant women. And so healthy, it's taken as a daily calcium supplement. So before you think about taking something slower than Tums, like Pepcid AC gel caps, which are every bit as slow as regular Pepcid, think again about
Tums.
My mother. My own mother thinks I'm capable of murder. Has this whole town gone crazy?
Honey, you're just going to have to try to stay calm.
Calm? And we have... Is that the prescribed reaction to finding out my own mother thinks I've got blood on my hands? You think I'm crazy? You defy all categories. All right, we already know you have no respect for me.
That's not true.
Yes, it is. All right, let's just get it out. We've had this conversation a million times. Let's have it again. Get it on the table. You have no respect for me. So how could you possibly love me?
I love you. I'm just trying to help you.
Help me?
And
with help like this, I need a lawyer and a restraining order.
Because I have seen you make mistakes.
Oh, mistakes? Is this
a
mistake?
And I've seen you cover them up.
So killing Alec Wallace was one of these mistakes. You're certifiable.
Listen, the police have been to my house twice in the past 2 days. I have to know what's going on. Just tell me you didn't do it. Tell me everybody's wrong and that it's a big mistake. Tell me you didn't do anything.
I don't have to justify myself to you or anyone else for that matter. I am taking my son, and I'm getting the hell out of here as fast as I can.
We have to do something, Aunt Lou. I'm not going to let them take you to prison.
See, they're not going to take me away anywhere. I didn't do anything. Darling, I don't have to do anything. I've got more power fire on the front page of my paper than any gun. They're not going to do anything to me. I'm innocent.
Yes, so is Margot, and look what they did to her.
You know, I have a feeling that the woman knows what she's doing.
Now, you listen to him. Listen to him. Do I look concerned? Not a bit. The only thing that's riling me up a little bit and getting under my skin and making me insane is the fact that Susan Stewart and I have a scarf in common.
But still, Aunt Lucinda...
Darling, don't you worry about it. There's nothing, no evidence on the scarf that could connect me to the murder of Alec Wallace.
Whoever did kill Wallace is a sick, selfish person. I mean, letting Margot sit in prison like that while innocent people are hounded by the police? This person should fry. Definitely fry.
Yeah, there's probably a special place in hell for somebody like that.
Got it all tagged?
Tagged, bagged, and ready to go.
Well, they look clean, but... maybe forensics can come up with something off one of them that'll tie the owner to the murder.
Julia, listen to Walsh. What do you think Emily did with Susan's scarf? Burned it?
I don't know. I know that of all three, that was the one I wanted most. Unless we can get some physical evidence off one of these, all we have is a videotape of a lady in an elevator and the testimony of a dead man.
I'll take him over.
Put a rush on it, tell him it's for Margot. And pray for a miracle, because that's the only thing that's gonna save her now.
The scarf was a good, solid link between Emily and the murder.
Without that...
Gabe, well, cheer up. Maybe our ghostly vision, Alec, could take the stand.
No, I'll find something. I'm gonna put Emily where she belongs.
The more I think about it, the more I realize now that Emily
just didn't kill Alec.
What about Julia? Does Julia fit any of the clues? The high heels, the fast footsteps, the crying?
I don't know.
What about Lucinda?
I don't know. I don't know. I can't remember anything more. I don't know. It's just, and time is running out. We don't have time. I mean, Christmas is just in a few days, and with the scarves and forensics for the next few days, probably won't be out until next week.
Well, that sounds about right.
And sentencing is next week. So, looks like I'm going to be spending New Year's in prison. Happy New Year.
I swear to you, I will not let you spend your life locked away. No one will ever take you away from me again. I mean, never.
All right, everyone, listen to Sticker!
Get down! Please. A five-position watering nozzle from Rainbird, which I found online and at thousands of retail stores. Now, it may be perfect for the garden, but a bank heist? I don't think so.
StoreRunner.com has shopping experts in every conceivable field, like Tracy Carrero in garden supplies.
Oh, my mother has a pair of those. Cut-and-hold rose pruners from Smith & Hawken, also available online and at 44 retail stores.
StoreRunner.com. Log on. Let's shop.
Colgate Total Toothpaste is used and recommended by more dental hygienists than any other brand. You have to figure. They know more about toothpaste than you do. Colgate Total. It's toothpaste, only better.
How Conair sees blue. Beautiful see-through blue. The Conair translucent dryers. 18.
Congratulations. To-